18 from the floor, but we know Jimmy Butler playoff time. Ice in his veins, the QB, he got around the reigning defensive player of the year.
Well, look at this. He ran the clock, and then he just came right back out, and now he's going to take him. Once that happened, I'm surprised that he was able to get that shoulder ahead, because he now had Giannis on his shoulder. So now, the fact that he was able to rise and play the glass was just a great professional move.
So Butler, unfazed by his difficult shooting day and the missed free throws from Adetokounmpo, come back to hurt Milwaukee. Butler now 6 of 9 on game tying or go-ahead field goals in his playoff career in the final minute of the fourth quarter or overtime. Best in the NBA over the last 25 seasons.
Well, see, they ran a very nice baseline screen for him. And then as he came up on the opposite side of the floor, you know, that pass was a dangerous pass, but no defender. Maybe they need kind of an attempt to go for the pass. So give Jimmy a ton of credit. He read the clock perfectly, and then he made a great move.
Overtime of game one underway between Miami and Milwaukee. If you are looking for the Mavericks and Clippers, game one, that has begun on ESPN2. We will join that game at the conclusion of this thriller. Middleton got partially blocked, but Giannis comes up with it and flushes it down.
Look, he's missed foul shots, but he's been a bear since that first one. He's now 9-for-25 from the field, and then with the 17 boards, you just gotta love what the guy has done in the game.
Robinson thought about pulling from deep, did not. Adebayo can't hit for 14. DiVincenzo hugs the rebound.
See, Butler is on holiday now, which has been interesting for the last two possessions.
But Middleton just took a shot up high from Robinson. A foul called, and you wonder if they might look at if this is anything more than a common foul. You could see a treasure trove of Milwaukee assistants hopping on their feet, wanting this to be reviewed. And it will indeed be reviewed. The following play is going to be reviewed to see if it meets the criteria for a player foul.
Look, there's the foul right there with the forearm up on Middleton on the rope. And the Middleton got it right in the face. Now you can just see that Robinson was trying to fight his way through the screen.
Now they're going to take a look to see whether or not this is a flagrant foul. Remember, any contact deemed to be unnecessary is all that's needed for it to qualify as a flagrant foul.
Now just keep an eye on Robinson right there. There he is. See, he catches him with the forearm right underneath the jaw as he's trying to fight through. That's definitely a foul. It depends upon the referees whether they think it's a flagrant one.
Caught him up high, which is something that's looked at as well. And obviously, an enormous call in this game. If this was upgraded to a flagrant, it would mean two shots for Middleton, who's an outstanding free throw shooter, and the basketball for Milwaukee. Whereas if it's a common foul, it's just going to be a side out of bounds for the Bucks, who lead by two here with 4:13 to go in overtime. The initial contact was in the chest, and then the hand drifted up towards the face of Middleton.
Well, it comes down to, during the course of this game, how many times
unnecessary contact into the chin, neck area above the shoulder, player penalty one.
So there you go, David Guthrie just gave it to you. Because the contact is deemed unnecessary, this is going to be a flagrant penalty one against Robinson, which means two free throws and the ball, and Duncan Robinson, Trevor Ariza, certainly not in agreement.
Now, unfortunately for him, he was fighting his way through with the forearm up in the upper chest. There's no doubt about it. Now, as they move in that, it went right up, and he catches him underneath the jaw. Now, that's definite. The call is correct about the facial part. But during the course of this game, there's been a ton of fighting through screens with physical contact on both ends of the court.
So Middleton goes 1-for-2 from the line. Milwaukee as a team now just 19-for-30 from the line. DiVincenzo leaves it short. Adebayo secures it for Miami. Milwaukee a 3-point lead. Neither team is led by more than 8 at any point in this game. Rogic with some space. Giannis gets back to him. Butler pounded by Holiday. Gives it up to Robinson. Quick trigger. And a connection on a three.
Listen, you gotta love this kid. He's got nerve, I'm telling you. He was coming parallel to the baseline. I was able to catch that basketball, turn up in the air, and knock in that three. That was a big
one. 102 all. Robinson now with 24 points. DiVincenzo gets blocked by Butler. And Milwaukee will have 4.9 to shoot.
Now keep an eye. Now right here. Here comes Robinson. There it is. The catch, and he's on his way up. And he turns in the air. And nothing but bottom of the net. Now give him a ton of credit now. He's 7-for-12.
All right. And that is going to be a travel against the Adetokunbo as Milwaukee turns it over.
Now this is just good defense, moving in the feet by Bam, and then also eliminated, I think, a potential Euro step. And he took it, you know, pretty strong.
Butler, a three? No. Rebound, Middleton. Butler shot it at just 24.5% from three this season.
Well, we know that it's a line drive.
Middleton, a three. Too strong. Dragic tips the rebound. Controlled by Butler. 102-102. 2 minutes and 46 seconds to go in overtime. And now Giannis is going to get called for the foul as he catches Butler up high, personal number 4 on Giannis.
In this overtime and at the end of the fourth.